Hi guys! Yeah, my dad's hands. First, I have to let my dog out for a pee. Hi guys, it's Ania from Interior Design Hub back again today with another video. Today, I want to teach you guys about the arts and crafts style. I just love this style. It's a personal favorite of mine. Beautiful, beautiful design style. And I feel like I'm seeing a lot of resurgence of aspects of it in today's world. So I'm gonna get into a little bit about the history of where the arts and craft movement started. And if you're in the US, you might actually know this as the mission style, which is another term that's used for the arts and crafts movement, as well as some key elements of what is authentic to this style and how you can bring some of these elements into your own home. I feel there's a lot of touches on this style, so I thought, you know what? I'm gonna dive into it because it's one of my personal favorites and hopefully you guys will learn something new or just more about it if you already knew about it. All right, let's get into it. All right, so what is the arts and crafts movement? So it's the later half of the 19th century that this really came into fruition. It challenged a previous Victorian era and really that kind of industrial movement where everything was made in a factory. And what was really, really key about the arts and crafts movement was that they really wanted to have things that was man-made. So things that were made by people that were good quality, made by hand. And they really wanted to move away from that highly manufactured items because they felt that it was low quality and it really just didn't have the longevity of something that was handmade. I feel like we're really seeing this again today. Like, think of the tiny house movement, for example. A lot of these are made, you know, by people that they want a simpler form of a lifestyle, right? So I think that's a really, this is, I think, why this was kind of resonating with me recently, is because I love the tiny house movement. I actually designed a tiny house with a girlfriend of mine who's also an interior designer. I'm going to show you guys a picture of that here because I don't know if you want to see a video on it, but comment below if you do. And also, if you're liking this content, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and the little bell, and you'll be notified every time I upload a video. And just in case you're wondering, I upload every Monday at 12:30 Eastern Standard Time. I'm really seeing a resurgence of this today, like I said, with the tiny house movement, but also, you know, things like Etsy and getting back into like finding things and reusing them and repurposing them. We're seeing a lot of stuff that can be reclaimed and recycled. And I just feel like that's a lot of this arts and crafts, like historic thought process. And we're seeing it again today. And even with biophilia and natural materials and sustainability, all of those things are really becoming very important today. And I just feel like we're trying to get better quality again, and we're seeing the value of having really good quality. So I wouldn't necessarily say I see this as a trend, maybe, maybe not, but more that I'm just seeing a lot of that get back into really good quality items and handmade things again, and just really, really understanding where what you have has come from. I find this fascinating. I also taught art history once, so I mean, I'm a bit of a nerd that way. But William Morris, okay? So William Morris is the key figure to this movement. He's really like the godfather of arts and crafts. I'm trying to make this exciting for everybody. So he was really the key person that wanted to move away from industrialism and get back into that handcrafted interior space. So he had his own interiors company where everything was handcrafted, and they really supported, you know, artisans and craftsmen and doing everything in the traditional way so that it was made, you know, to last a lifetime. It was made not just by local artisans, but it was actually made to last the test of time, so that when people would purchase something from them or they would have them do an interior space for them, they wouldn't have to worry about it because it was built to last. It was a tank. One of the things that he actually, I think this is where I'm seeing it come today, is he started doing wallpapers and prints, and these were all handmade. I'm going to show a bunch of images of them, but he basically was producing these very ornate patterns, but not ornate like small little things. He was doing those big, bold, floral patterns, which we're seeing again today, and leaf motifs, and you know, the birds and the like, the big flowers. And I look at this and I'm like, this is so on trend for today. Like, I love this look, and we're seeing it more and more, that oversized pattern. And a lot of it is really, I feel, the essence of, you know, a William Morris classic pattern. I think that's where a lot of the inspirations come from, because it really does have that vibe. And when you see these that I'm going to show you on the screen, you're going to be like, that's not today. Like, that's not current. Like, these are actually from back in the day, from like the turn of the century. Isn't that cool? So other than just the wallpapers that he designed, which, I mean, these are just fantastic, and I'd probably put any single one of them up in one of my homes or one of my interiors. One of my homes. I don't have more than one home. In my house, I would put this up in my house. He did a bunch of woven fabrics, he did a bunch of wallpapers, but he also even got into carpets, rugs, and tapestries. But I do want to get into my absolute favorite type of design through this era, and that is the craftsman house. This is my personal favorite. It's not a trend thing. I just love the style of home. I feel like it just is inviting and welcoming, and every single thing about these homes, for me personally as an interior designer, inspire me. So what are some of the key elements of a craftsman style home? Typically built from wood, stone, and brick, so no siding here. So a lot of times with the craftsman style home, you'll see a lot of things like built-in cabinetry and built-in furniture. A lot of really integrated features within the home is very much done by hand or handcrafted, or has a very traditional look. One of the things with the craftsman style is really getting into, you know, that unity of design, the architecture of the space, making sure that there's a lot of form and function and thought put into how the entire space flows. And that is very, very integral to a craftsman home. Another really big symbol of a craftsman home is the fireplace. It is like the central focal point of the home. It usually has a larger mantle. It usually has some built-ins next to it. Once you see it, and I'll show you some images of it, you'll be like, oh yeah, I've seen that before, because it's a very typical way of doing a fireplace in this style of home. Another one of my absolute favorite features of this style is their big front porches. Like, I just love the thought of sitting on a big front porch and just, you know, watching, you know, the rain or whatever, like sitting outside with my cup of tea. And I just, that's what I don't know why. I just, can you tell I love this style? Cause like, I really love this style. I don't have a big porch. I wish I had a big porch on my house, but sadly I do not. So they usually have also like a low pitched roof with wide eaves on it. It's very, you know, there is a very particular look to this style of home. Like once you see this, you'll spot them if you have them around you. Exposed beams are another really big feature of this home. From the inside to the outside, you generally will see exposed beams, which we see a lot of that happening again today, you know, seeing some of that exposed beams being brought out or faux in even, because people really like that look. Another thing, what shifted with the arts and crafts movement was, in a Victorian home, you typically have segmented rooms, and that's very, very traditional of a Victorian home. In the arts and crafts movement, what they wanted to do is actually open up those floor plans, and they wanted to have a lot more movement in the space and a lot more flow. And it was really designed to break down barriers and not have all those little incremental rooms. It still had zones, like you had a dining room and a living room, just like we do today, but it's definitely was a big change from what had been happening previously. And I think that's one thing that, I mean, not even arts and crafts, but that movement has continued. People really like a more open floor plan. So that's very indicative of this style. So how can you guys, you know, bring some of the arts and crafts into your own home? I'm gonna get into it for you. So bold patterns, like bringing in that big oversized floral patterns. I mean, we are seeing this today. It is happening, people. This is, I mean, I'm saying this isn't super on trend, but I guess it is. Some of it is on trend again. So that is actually a way to bring in, you know, the arts and crafts style into your home. The color palette, I think there's a modern version of it. I'm going to include an image of like what I would think would be the modern version of, you know, the arts and crafts color palette. I don't see a lot of people using this, but I do feel like you could use touches of this, even if it's not necessarily like painting all your walls these colors, but you could totally bring it into your, you know, finishes and your materials like throw pillows and rugs and different things. So the typical color palette you would see with the arts and crafts movement would be, you know, hunter green, burnt oranges, dark grays, sky blues, not my favorite color, golds, muted rose. Anybody remember rose? Anyone from the 80s here? Because you remember rose. That was a very popular color. And burgundies. Obviously, I don't think all of these colors right now are in, but like the hunter green is back. I mean, that has been a really big trend right now. Green is, I think, the color of 2019, or was it 2020? I don't know. It's one of the colors of the year. But it's green is really, really back. They're not saying it's a resurgence of the arts and crafts movement, but you're definitely seeing a lot of this in what's on trend right now. Also, incorporating furniture with clean lines and made from natural materials like a rattan, and you're really seeing this a lot right now. Like I'm gonna include a picture here of the chair that I have seen in so many videos. Like I watch a few videos of, you know, girls doing like try-ons and stuff, and I've seen it more than one. So it's a very popular chair. It's from IKEA, so it's affordable, but it's got that feeling of arts and crafts. And I feel like once you see it, you're gonna see it more. So that's a way to bring it in. Also, another thing with furniture is like large, you know, cabinets and built-ins. Like you can't always do built-ins, but like large cabinets and benches and, you know, made of woods. And those are things that you can do to actually bring in some of that more authentic like arts and crafts to your space. But my recommendation, if you really want to bring it into your home, keep to the authenticity of it and actually go to like a farmer's market and, you know, get a bench or a cabinet that's made by somebody from there. Something that's not mass manufactured, something that's made by hand. Or go to Etsy and support some of those local businesses, because honestly, that's really the bare minimum of arts and crafts, like not even from a design side, is really trying to get stuff that's handcrafted. Another big thing, which I don't see many people using, but I definitely think you could find a way to bring it in, is the use of stained glass. Now, as I was looking at this, I was like, how would I use stained glass today? And I actually did find an image of like a really modern stained glass kind of funky thing. But I don't know if I'd use that in my house, but I thought if you like it, it's kind of neat. It's kind of cool. I feel like, again, I'm bringing back the tiny house. I feel like in a tiny house, it would look really cool. Like if you had like a transom window and then you did like a bit of a stained glass, like just kind of coming in on one side, like in this honeycomb, like just two-tone pattern, like kind of modern. That's where I think it would look really cool. So that's just my personal like thought. I'm sure if I could, I'm not a residential designer, so I'm just kind of like spitballing what I think it could work at, but I mean, stained glass is like, it's beautiful when you see it, but I don't know how to always use it in a current setting. But it really depends on your personal taste, because you can totally bring it in a nice way. So I just wanted to include for you guys, this is from Ben Pentreth. I don't know if I'm saying it. So benpentreth.com. I'm going to include a link somewhere. And this was just through like when I was searching and doing some of my research for some more like current stuff on this. He does like modern version. I don't know if it's all he does, but he did this house that I found, a modern take on the arts and crafts movement. And what I wanted to show you guys is that arts and crafts doesn't have to be old and stuffy. I feel like when you see arts and crafts, like traditionally, it's very, very dark and heavy. And I feel like that's not at all what people want these days. However, I do see a resurgence in it. And so what you see in his spaces is the bold patterns, how you mix that in a current way that doesn't look old and dated and dark. And that's what I love about it, because he uses a lot of those colors that I talked about, that I mentioned previous, but in like a modern way with just a hint of it. So what he's done is he's painted out a lot of the wood paneling that would be traditionally left in a natural wood state with like a vanilla tone, or, you know, like a mushroom tone, which is very also typical of the arts and crafts colorway. However, it gives it a more modern feeling, because that's one thing with, you know, when you look at old pictures of arts and crafts, a lot of it is wood and it's left in its natural state. What he's done with a lot of his spaces is left the beams exposed in the natural wood. done the walls and the paneling and a painted finish that just looks so beautiful and so inviting and so modern. Like, it's so current. There's so many styles that I love, but one thing I love about arts and crafts is it feels very homey. Like, you feel like you could go in there and like lounge in the couch and actually just really get comfortable in the space. It doesn't feel like a magazine in the sense of like I can't touch anything. Like, it definitely does not have that feeling to it, which is what I think I love about it, is that it's very inviting. It's very like, come sit, relax. You don't have to worry about putting your feet up on the table. It's okay, you can do it. We'll be fine, because we're made well. And if you really enjoy this style, I can tell you one thing, is that it will definitely stand the test of time. I hope you enjoyed the video. I had my little friend with me today. Until next time, bye. Which I don't know what this is, but that's my finger showing up a bell. My dog. Oh my gosh. Okay, this dog is whining. This is my dog. Isn't he cute? He's really old. Okay, he wants to sit with me, so he's now part of the video. He's really old. He's like, I love him. My fur baby, right? Yeah. Whiny bubble. Okay.